Dog Eye Scourge here, the voice of reason for all seasons here, and I'm going to be talking about how Hollywood has been dropping the ball for anime adaptions for some time now. And I just got to say, after watching Speed Racer the second time, at least the first time in 7 years, I have to say that the adaption is pretty good. It really lives up to the source material, everything from the races to the characters and everything else. And I figured since Hollywood, or rather Warner Brothers, was trying out this new film, this was over 8 years ago, as an experiment, it seemed logical that they would actually choose this one, you know, as a safe bet that if they could bring a new audience for this particular anime adaption, others would follow. I guess the next logical step would be something bigger, like, say, for example, Dragon Ball or Sailor Moon or Death Note or even One Piece or something along those lines. But considering how badly it flopped in theaters, which is quite a mystery to me because it was everything that one could ever want in adaption, it respected the characters and what they looked like, it respected the races, which was totally amazing. I personally don't understand what happened, but I guess name recognition had something to do with it. Many people don't know what Speed Racer is. Now, I'm not a Speed Racer fan, I'm an anime fan. And seeing that they were going with this soft entry as far as movies are concerned, I figured the next logical step would, of course, be Dragon Ball. And what we got was less than stellar. In fact, to many, it's an abomination of a film. Not only did it not follow the source material or respect even the author, it did something completely different that no one ever expected, and people hated it. And as a result, it kind of turned out to be a blessing in disguise because of its massive failure. At least with fans, but not at the box office, yes, I kid you not, it actually made more money than Speed Racer. Speed Racer made only $90 million out of $128 million of its budget. And Dragon Ball Evolution made $60 million out of its $30 million budget. So you gotta wonder how that even works. But despite this, it actually succeeded in the box office but flopped with fans. And as a result, many projects have been resulted. Many fan projects, for example, the Dragon Ball Z Light of Hope on YouTube. Everyone knows what that is. And it's an excellent adaptation of Dragon Ball Z. Of course, we also have the Western anime, Last Airbender, which didn't do too well, obviously, because, well, it was a major flop by handing it over to Shyamalan. People hate that director now. Not that I have personal grudges against the man, but they could have picked someone better, maybe a fan, to do the film who knew and understood the source material. Because everything from the character direction, the characters, the music, the pacing, the acting, everything went wrong in that particular adaption, and nobody liked it at all. It was supposed to be a franchise, and obviously didn't get a sequel because it was so bad. So basically, Hollywood has kind of screwed up as far as anime adaption, which leads me to the final point. They're planning on bringing yet another adaption over to the West based on Ghost in the Shell, and I'm a bit worried about that adaption considering the track record thus far. The first being Speed Racer that somehow flopped for some reason, even though it was a decent adaptation of what the cartoon was, and Dragon Ball, which was a complete abomination since it didn't follow the source material at all. And then we have Avatar, or The Last Airbender, that was a beloved cartoon based on anime that didn't do well at all because of bad direction, bad acting, etc. And now we're getting yet a fourth entry. And many people are concerned considering they're already casting, they're not casting any Asian actors for this, and I'm not going to spoil who's going to be acting as whom, but the bottom line is it's going to be done with a Western perspective, which is also another problem because of how complicated the Eastern style of the storytelling is. Character development, basically it's based on who lives, who dies, who's real, who's not. It's mostly more philosophical than most, and you can't dumb that down. And knowing how Hollywood is and dumbing down material like this, it'll be very questionable on how they actually adapt this particular franchise. That being said, what do you guys think out there? Should this adaption come to be? Should they take their time to fix it up before they release it to Western audiences? Should they even consider the source material, because obviously they haven't done it very well in the last couple of adaptions. And as always, rate, comment, and subscribe, and share my video. See you later.